Hi guys, it's Chuff here again, and this is a bit of an update as to what's on the desk and what I'm doing. I've got quite a lot on, as you can probably guess with all the stuff I bought from Games Day. What you see before you is currently the Fellblade built. There will be a video somewhere on the screen. I'll probably try and get it in here, maybe. I went to Don's last weekend and you can see us in high speed building these things, which were interesting. Some expletives and foul language was definitely used. It's required for all Forge World builds of this size and ilk. I have undercoated it. I have contemplated whether to do a painting tutorial on this thing, but it's pretty much too big for my desk and the camera and for me to work, because right now I am probably about 3 foot away from it because of the camera. The two quad link las cannons which go in here and here quite nicely, I haven't glued on because it'll be a bugger to paint these and then with them on, so I'm going to paint them and put them on. There is quite a weight to all this resin. This piece is quite nice. Getting this back into shape, it was just slightly warped, not much, so that was easy enough. Hair dryer time, really. This piece, you think it would sit on this, but it doesn't. If you actually look at all the images on the Forge World website, there's this lip that goes over here, so it goes round. So it was a little gap, so I had the green stuff behind it. So yeah, there's some nice bits of detail on this. I did contemplate putting the tank crew that you get on it in, but you can get this in two formats, one driven by Imperial Guard, the other driven by Space Marines. So if I shove Space Marines in and it's driven by the Guard, so Ballistic Skill 3, it'll look a little out of place. So I've shut them, but I like these little steps and stuff, so we'll contemplate something. But I do really want to do a high detail job on this ultimately, so it's going to take quite a bit of time going through all the processes. The kit itself is part resin, part plastic. With all part resin, part plastic kits, it's a pain in different ways. The plastic part of the kit is literally, let me just turn it upside down. This is from Baneblade Shadow Swordy kit, and then the inside here, this plate, as it were, is plastic, and here, this bit you'll see is plastic. Then you've got the lovely tracks that you do struggle to keep them straight once you put these side panels on, but it's doable, it's quite nice. These tanks are a little messy, if you ask me. Still not a big fan on those. I love the engine stack. With these, it looks big and beefy compared to the Shadow Sword one. What I intend to do is fully paint this, and I'm going to put like an icon there, but I'll probably green stuff build one, paint it and then glue it on once it's all done. So yeah, that's the little project for that. My painting tutorial vid on the jet bike seemed to go down well, so I'm going to start one on a Apothecary Mark IV. So he's going to be fun to do, to say the least. White is one of the hardest colours to paint, so stay tuned and we'll see how that goes. The Angron model is being, the draw is going to be this coming Saturday, and I'll be doing it live so everyone can see that it's genuine. I haven't worked out how I'm going to sort it out. I might use a system someone else has used, which is randomly generate a number based on the number of pages, go to that page number of comments and count the amount of comments, do a random generator on that, and that person will win as long as they say entered on that comment and that they're subscribed to my channel. I'd also like to give a shout out to a good buddy of mine from Red Steel Alton. His link will be in the description below, as well as a link to his Facebook page, so you can actually have a look at his work. He's doing commission stuff now. At the moment I think he's doing a couple of pieces that he's going to put on eBay, and it helps show his level of painting to you guys, which is actually quite high. So I'd go over there, have a look at it, and if you've got anything you need doing, give him a shout, and he'll sort you out quite well. Trying to think what else I've got to tell you. I have, once I've done the painting tutorial for this little guy, it's me painting this. So I can't see that taking too long, probably about 3 or 4 days to paint this. And then next big project, I've got a Warhound in the process and a few little bits. I might do the odd little bit whilst I'm building the Warhound. Please comment, rate and subscribe, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Take care.